spectroscopy, their argument is that that is really represent the sleeping anatomy when the patient is sleeping. Okay, so some center practice that. We also initially practiced that long ago, but we don't do it anymore. Why? We are not prone, or we are not what do you call it? We are not really what's the word? We don't really practice. Why? Because it doesn't tell us that much information, and you can say that it's not a natural sleep. Basically, if you give some sedation, this is sedated sleep. It can relax your muscle a bit more, and you're prone to get a bit more obstruction than the normal sleep. Can you do it in a natural sleep? Boleh, but it's not often possible because this patient will wake up. If you don't give sedation, you just patient tidur dia, you jolok hidung dia, dia will jaga nanti. They will wake up. So we don't practice that regularly, but we know some centers do practice this. Any more question? Now I'm sending the PowerPoint to you, Anis.
Okay, doctor.
Sorry, is somebody trying to? So you want me to repeat what? Oh, the questionnaire. Okay, it's called. There are several questionnaires available. Berlin, as in Berlin, a place in German. Berlin questionnaire. Lagi, Epworth sleepiness scale. Epworth, Epworth sleepiness scale. Stop bang questionnaire. Another one. Stop, berhenti, bang, hentak. Stop bang questionnaire. That those three is enough. That those three are the common ones we use.
Doctor, for stop bang tu, dia screening ke diagnosis? Screening kan? Ke macam mana?
Screening. All of these are screening.
Kalau nak diagnose tu yang...
Diagnostic, you must do sleep study. Diagnostic, you must do sleep study, eh? Apa kau balik? Any more question? I don't know which one is the send button. Ayo, I'm so bad at this lah. Jaja, eh? Doctor Yahya's.
You read about it. Is it a different category?
Can you repeat the question? What is the what?
Central sleep apnea. Because I do come across it when I read about articles. Is it the same category under sleep apnea or different?
The way we manage them is the same. But central sleep apnea is not obstructive sleep apnea. Okay, the definition of central sleep apnea is that you don't have a signal from the higher center, the respiratory center, for the end organ of respiration, which is your lung, to breathe. So basically, you have apnea because you have no signal from central for you to breathe. Okay? Okay, got that? Well, obstructive sleep apnea is, there is a signal, but your end organ of respiration, which is your lung, fail to breathe because there is obstruction somewhere in the periphery. Some even put it as a peripheral obstruction, central and peripheral obstruction. Okay, now how do you differentiate between central or peripheral obstruction? You can tell from your sleep study the component of central obstruction. Okay. Let's go back to the sleep studies now. There are a few things you monitor again, all these parameters. How do you tell that it is central? When you detect that patient's having apnea, okay, dia tak bernafas, tak ada parameter for them, everything is flat. You detect apnea when you put airflow sensor dekat mouth and the nose. So there is no sensor. So that means there is no airflow through the mouth and through the nose. Then you know that patient is having apnea. But is it central apnea or peripheral ataupun obstructive apnea? How can you tell? Anybody have any suggestion? Anybody?
Again, the 30.
Again, eh? Again. Apa ni? Did you hear me? You apa nama ni? Central and peripheral definition tadi, you understand, eh? Central, yeah. There's no signal from the brain for your lung to breathe. There's no signal. Peripheral, there is signal, but your lung cannot be breathing because of other obstruction in the upper airway. Okay, got that? No?
Yes, doctor, yes.
Yeah, you got that? Eh? Okay, so now, what I'm trying to tell you that you can tell whether the apnea the patient had at one point is central or peripheral ataupun obstructive. You can tell from the sleep study. How you can tell?
Look at EEG.
EEG, you can tell. If you are good at reading EEG, you can tell whether this is a central or peripheral. That's right. But a more simpler way to see that is
movement.
Yeah, movement. Yes, movement. Movement. Abdominal and chest movement. In those with central apnea, there is no movement or effort to breathe. Because of lacking signal, tak ada signal, if there is no signal, then abdomen and chest movement will be flat. But in obstructive apnea, there should be some movement. That means they are trying to breathe, but they cannot because of obstruction in the airway. But you see some movement. But if you see no movement at all, then it is central apnea. Boleh?
Boleh.
Understood. Okay.
So central ni dia neurologi lah. Yang obstructive tu mechanical ke macam mana?
It's mechanical, but often when we diagnose obstructive sleep apnea, ada less than maybe 20% component of central apnea in it is still acceptable. We still term it as obstructive sleep apnea. It's normal to have a mixed apnea. It's normal to have mixed apnea, but the central component shouldn't be more than 20% of all the apneas they have. Faham?
Faham.
All right. Okay, any more questions?